Get ready to match the stars. Bill Cullen, Brett Summers, Jack Klugman, Cass Elliott, Richard Dawson, and Loretta Swit as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
I thought a brief, brisk swim before the show would be nice. It's a pretty deep pool, though. Hello there.
Hi.
Are they ready, John?
Ready.
Okay, we're ready, too. Are you ready over here on the
line?
Yes.
Are you ready on the firing line? Let's say hello to our two players, Eleanor Proley and Bill Goldstein. Eleanor's our current champ. She's won a lot of money. How much money have you won?
$5,600.
$5,600. What are you going to do with that?
Spend it fast.
You're going to spend it fast?
Yes.
Okay. Well, we're almost ready to start a game. We ought to find out who this fellow is, Bill Goldstein. Tell us where you're from, Bill.
Well, I went to school in Oregon, and I live in West L.A. now, and I teach at a junior college.
What do you teach?
Social sciences. This semester, I'm teaching economics.
All right. Good luck to you, Bill.
I may take that up.
You may take that up.
Great.
We'll start this game right after we finish these messages. That's the way it goes.
Economics, you mean?
All right, we're ready to begin this game. Bill Goldstein, you know that you and Eleanor will be answering questions, trying to match our six celebrities. The one who's done that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner and have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. Now, some of our contestants find some questions harder than others. That's why we put it up to you. Make a selection, please.
I'll take B.
He wants B. Here it is, folks.
And
everybody,
I'll take
please.
Him.
And I'll give her away at the wedding.
That's another show. The old gambler warned, never play poker with Raquel. She always keeps a pair of aces in her blank. You do too, madam.
That's the first time that's ever happened.
Yes, everybody's ready. Oh, you didn't take long at all in making up your mind there. Bill, we ask your response now. Never play poker with Raquel. She always keeps a pair of aces in her...
I can only visualize chest.
In her chest.
No, well, bra, really.
You don't
that's
mean checkers,
I mean.
Dear.
Bra, right?
Yeah. Oh, you mean bra.
I mean bra, right.
Okay, bra is your answer. Okay. Bra is his answer.
Bra is his answer?
I mean, he can't say chest with a lady. What's wrong with him? He hasn't been around much. He's very young.
Yeah.
What do you say, Bill?
I'm sorry. I like him young.
He said bra.
He said bra, that's his answer.
Yeah, that's enough there for a full house. You did say a pair of aces.
A pair of aces.
I cleaned it up a little bit and got bodice out of it. I don't know. It's
bodice.
The same,
it's a
same
bodice.
Place.
No,
it's
certainly not. That is not a bodice is a thing that comes down here.
That's all
goes
you
right
know.
Down.
Oh,
that's a
brother.
Laces up in the back
that's
here.
That's a bodice.
That's a bodice.
That is mine doesn't lace in the back. You're talking about the old-fashioned kind.
Yeah, all right, Brett, what do you say?
Actually, that's where she parks her car.
In her bodice?
Yeah. Well, in her cleavage.
That's in her cleavage. No, Brian.
There,
cleavage. Oh, that did match.
Well, of course, that's a...
Well, I don't know. I was waiting for the ding-dong.
What did he have? All I wish is, boy, that this was the ace of clubs and this was the ace of diamonds.
Yeah.
What say you, lady?
I say
blouse.
In her blouse.
No you match. Do?
Ah, you're so.
Why would you say that?
Okay, Richard, we need a response from you.
Yeah, whenever you play, by the way, poker with Raquel, you need two jacks or better to open. So I put bra.
I wasn't going to say that.
Yes. Now, Loretta.
I'm definitely in the wrong area. Garter.
Oh, in the garter.
Well,
we weren't talking about Marlena Dietrich, you know.
That's gin rummy.
Poker's here.
Okay, I would like to make a statement.
You didn't do too bad with that, Bill Goldstein. You got three, and now let's see how Eleanor, our current champ, does with this. If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a blank. If the pilgrims had landed at the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a blank.
Do you think I've smartened up as the weeks have gone
I think
by?
You're doing very well, and I love the way you're wearing your hair. You look stunning, my dear.
Wait, she'll give it to you. You'll try.
Everybody ready over there? Eleanor, you're thinking deeply about this, are you?
Yes.
How would you fill that in? If the pilgrims in the land of the North Pole, your mother would spend Thanksgiving stuffing a...
An Eskimo. That's all I can think of from Alaska. Up in the North Pole, yeah. An Eskimo.
You don't have to explain it. Bad enough as it is. She says...
Yeah, I heard.
Eskimo. It's the most winning answer we've had on the show in 17 weeks here. All right, Bill. If you say Eskimo.
You can do it, Bill.
I am, penguin.
Penguin, yeah.
My mother stuffed an Eskimo.
Really? All right. Brett, what did you say?
Actually, I think Eleanor has it the wrong way round, but who am I to criticize? Seal.
A seal. Okay. Haven't got an Eskimo yet, Eleanor. We're trying for you, though.
Listen, Eleanor, I've had an Eskimo, and you know, they're not so
special. I'd rather stuff Raquel Walsh's bra. Penguin.
Penguin. All right. Now, Cass Elliott.
Actually, this is known as the turkey of the north, the penguin.
The turkey of the north, yes. All right.
What's the seal?
One glass of wild penguin. That's a little Texas joke. No, actually, penguins are what they stuff. And I did that once when I was a little tipsy. Turned out it was a head waiter, but the thought was there, wasn't it?
That's the turkey of the show.
I see so you lay him, Jack, and I'll sell him.
Okay. Another penguin. So we had all penguins and no Eskimos, sorry to say, Eleanor. So at the end of round one, it's 3-0 in favor of the challenger. We'll go to round two after we go to these messages for you. Okay, here we go with round two. If you're all ready, Bill, would you make a selection?
I'll take B.
B is what he wants. And last time out, Bill, you matched three celebrities, Brett, Jack, and Richard, so the three of you will not participate, the
you
others will.
You mean to tell me I can't get on his side again?
No. Nope. Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the blank.
I have a good answer.
There's the question. You get it, Bill? Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the blank.
You're out.
All right. You're ready, Bill, are you? Did you finish?
I'm as ready as I'll ever be. I'll put my little thing right. I always forget this.
Okay, there we go. Now we get a response from Bill Goldstein. Nobody knows this, but William Shakespeare did all of his writing in the...
In the... John.
In the John? You know, if we had the time, I'd ask you to describe what a John looked like in those days, because I don't think they had him, do they? I don't know. He says the John.
Yeah, that means in a forest.
In
that
the
was
John?
Europe,
yes.
In the forest.
A rose by any other name would smell as sweet.
Oh, look at that. Okay.
I know I'm not playing, but I said raw.
In the raw. All right, Cass, you're playing.
In the nude.
In the nude. All right. And now we go to Loretta.
They most certainly had them in those days. John.
John. All right. To each his own. So, Bill, you're up to five. Now, Eleanor, you've got to match five celebrities to achieve a tie. Six will win the game. Listen carefully now. Roses are red, violets are blue. The meatloaf you served me tastes exactly like...
He must have come over to our house for dinner. Come over, been over.
Are you contemplating your...
My navel.
Oh, I see. There she is. Okay, she's out of it now. You're finished, right, Brett? Okay.
What?
You're finished.
Yeah, everybody finished. Oh, your light was on, and I... All right. Now, Eleanor, roses are red, violets are blue. The meatloaf you served me tastes exactly like...
Glue.
The audience thinks the winning answer is glue. Let's see what you said, Bill Cullen.
Comes to show what the audience knows. Glue.
Glue. All right, Brett.
Well, there are a lot of things that rhyme with blue, but glue's best.
Glue. There's two. Two for glue. What are you
supposed to taste any other way but by glue?
Glue. Need two more to tie. Three to win, Cass.
I'm embarrassed. A shoe?
Shoe.
I love you, Cass.
That's all right. She's okay.
If any trouble, she's going to come over and fall on the front row. Now, she's my friend.
All right.
That was a dumb answer.
Yeah. You must match the two remaining celebrities, and let's see if it happens.
Oh, thank you. Very sticky response.
Glue. All right. One more for a tie, and it's up to you, Loretta.
Oh, the pressure. Well, I was a little more kind about her cooking. I said stew.
Stew. So the winner is Bill Goldstein. Come on down, Bill. All right, there's $100 for you together with our congratulations. Stand by for a moment while we tell Eleanor that she's going to be leaving here with $5,600 and our best wishes.
Thank you.
Eleanor Crowley. Thank you. Bye, Eleanor. Okay. Well, Bill, you've been around here long enough to know how it goes, so shall we have a go at it?
All right. Let's see what happens.
Sure. Let's see what happens. Cool cat.
Both
huh?
of you get out of here. Go on.
Bill, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Rip blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100. Okay, now, three celebrities are allowed to give a little help. Name one.
Richard.
Rip Van Winkle.
Ah, shut up. All right, another one.
Brett.
Rip off.
Yeah. Rip off. Okay.
Cass.
Cass Elliott.
Rip cord.
Rip cord. So, you've got Rip Van Winkle, rip off, and rip cord. You may give us one of those as the answer, or another one if you'd like, one of your own.
I'm going to go with Rip Van Winkle.
Okay. He wants to go with Rip Van Winkle.
You'll like him. He's a nifty little dancer.
I went with him for years.
Yeah.
He was okay.
He has a very long beard, you know,
dear. A little
hairy,
but what the heck. Okay, Rip Van Winkle is the answer he's looking for, and that's what we're all looking for. So let's find out if it's under the $100 response. Rip Torn is an answer that none of us thought about.
They forget.
Yes.
It's a so-so answer there. Okay. We're still looking for a Rip Van Winkle. Here is the $250 response. Rip off is up there. That's the one Brett gave you. Okay. Third and last chance for Rip Van Winkle. Where are you, Rip? Are you under the $500 response?
Yes.
Yes, you are. Congratulations. Okay. Now, Bill, you're up to $600. You've won the $500 here. That means you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to... Yeah, you want to open your jacket for that?
Why don't you take it off, sweetheart?
Now, to get the $5,000, you must match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis, and the time has come to choose that person.
Well, I'm going to go with Richard.
Sure. Yeah.
Thank God.
Okay.
I must warn you, I don't kiss on the first date.
You'd be better than Rip Van Winkle.
Well, thank you.
You kissed me on the first date, Vicky.
Rip Van Winkle did?
He's going to get ready to... You face me. Okay. Just stand right there like that. Okay. Here is the $5,000 question, Richard. Write your answer to this, if you would, please. Apple blank. Apple blank. Okay, he's finished his answer. Now, Bill, it's time for us to give us your answer. How do you fill in the blank? Apple?
Pie.
Okay. That seems to be the favorite with the audience. Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
All the trouble I had at school, I never thought I'd write pie for a school.
Who's that screaming and hooping and hollering? You got a friend there?
I've got a couple of friends out there.
Okay. What plans do you have for your money, if any?
A trip.
Where?
I was thinking of maybe Carnival in Rio, something like that. How about that?
Okay, let's go, shall we? Listen, you've done very well. You're up to $5,600. You're still the champ. You're going to play another game. But first, we've got to pass along these messages. Now, what do you say we welcome this new player, Antoinette Osborne? Hi, Antoinette.
Hi. How are you doing?
Pretty lady, huh? Yeah. A very pretty lady. Where's this pretty lady from?
Los Angeles.
What do you do?
I keep my baby at home. I have a little six-month-old baby girl.
You have a six-month-old baby girl, and mm-hmm. she occupies all of your time.
Oh, yes.
I bet you're a good mother.
Yes.
Okay. Good luck to you here. You know that you and Bill will be answering questions, trying to match our celebrities, and the one who does that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, and we'll have a go at the super match where you can win over $5,000. You ready?
Yes.
Okay, I'll push this button, which is here somewhere. There it is. And you're going to pick B. All right, she picked B.
You're married, Jim.
Yes, I am married. Okay. The Jolly Green Giant's belly button is so big, you can blank in it. Yes.
I never doubted you for a second.
The Jolly Green Giant's belly button is so big, you can blank in it.
Bizarre.
A room with a view and
a little dispatch would be...
Oh, I'm sorry. Are we all ready to go? Oh.
I didn't hear anything sharp.
All right. Now, Antoinette, the Jolly Green Giant's belly button is so big you can blank in it.
Swim.
Swim. Okay, she says swim. That sounds okay to me. How's it sound to you, Bill?
I've never been all that active. I like to sleep there.
Go to sleep. Just curl up and... Yeah. Okay, you swim or you sleep, Brett.
Bill Cullen said when that girl came out, I love her act. I think that means he thinks she's pretty.
Yeah.
I can't imagine why.
Great.
She's beautiful.
What does that say?
Oh, soup!
Make soup.
He can make soup in his belly button. Okay.
Some of the soup she makes tastes like she made it in his belly. So I try to hide in it.
You can hide in his belly button. No swim yet, Antoinette, I'm sorry to say. Let's see if we get a swimmer here, Cass.
His belly button is so big that you can swim in it.
Swim in it. All right.
Well, when I got there, it was the dry season, no water, so I just sat down.
Oh.
I felt silly, but what can you do in there? You know what I mean?
No water.
Thank you.
You could have gone through the motions. And...
Oh, well, I always go through the motions, according to my divorce papers. Anyway.
Loretta?
I felt the same way Dick did. Sit.
You sit in the belly button.
I wish I'd been there at the same time.
Yes. So you scored one match there, Antoinette, and we'll get to your end of this round, Bill. Well, first, we've got to pass along a message, and then you hurry back for more of Match Game 73. Okay. Well, I'm sorry to say we've run out of time, but I trust both of you will be back here to continue Match Game 73. Will you do that? Good. Yeah. Look forward to seeing you. We'll look forward to seeing you next time.
Seeing you. Certainly look forward
Brett
to seeing
Brett and
you.
The new Perry Mason.
Yes, Doc.
Jack and the Odd Couple.
I forgot to say I can't make it to
my car.
I didn't know I had any back.
What are you?
Oh, it's just a note that came. It said Dick Van Dyke is at 9:30 Mondays. I don't know who that possibly could be for.
That's right.
I think Richard, he fell for it,
on
folks.
On the Dick Van Dyke Show, did you know that?
I did know it, because I'm Dick, you know, and that's, well. You hear these things.
Very good. Okay, Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73, hoping you'll join us next time. Thank you for being with us.
Today's consolation prizes are from Montgomery Ward's Big Ball Catalog, a full-size velvet touch electric blanket. Stay cozy warm with 11 comfort settings from the Montgomery Ward Catalog. And an assortment of party time cocktail mixes, the mixes that have both quality and variety, now make a perfect drink every time. And Honeysuckle White Turkey from Ralston Purina, the premium basted turkey in the red checkerboard package. Honeysuckle Turkey, the Ralston Purina Checkerboard. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.